In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for the great gift of our lives and our vocations. Send forth an abundance of your joy and peace upon all those we love and encounter. Unite us to your Son for the greater glory and the salvation of souls. Amen. The first thing we're going to do is to give you a cross to carry. Sister Irene. Sister Monica. Sister Eilish. Sister Karen. Sister Claire. Sister Kayla. Sister Jenna. Sister Autumn. Sister Grace. Sister Jacinta. Sister Rory. Sister Mary Claire. Sister Amber. Sister Jersey. Sister Catherine. Sister Genevieve. Sister Meg. Sister Bridget. Did I miss anyone? We had plenty of crosses, so anyway.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord said to Abram, "Go forth from the land of your kinsfolk and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who will bless you and curse those who curse you. All the communities of the earth shall find blessing in you." Abram went as the Lord directed him. The word of the Lord. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him, all you peoples. For steadfast is his kindness towards us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Come after me, says the Lord, and I will make you fishers of men. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. As Jesus was walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and his brother Andrew, casting a net into the sea. They were fishermen. He said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." At once they left their nets and followed him. He walked along from there and saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. He called them, and immediately they left their boat and their father and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
Sisters, I want to welcome the Corona postulants to our community, our Dominican community. We've been waiting for you and heard about you. And anyway, we're so glad that the day has finally come and you're here. I can't help but I have to thank Sister Joseph Andrew, who works tirelessly for vocations. I'm sure she pushed you along, right? And I'm sure that in her assistance, I'm sure she pushes them along also. You know, when I heard that there are 18 postulants and there are 18 novices, I thought there must be something special about the number 18. So I'm not a trivia person, but I did look it up, and I want to show you. I'm just going to say it was unbelievable. I only picked out a few, so I'll let you know a few. Ulysses Grant was the 18th president of the United States. The highest grossing movie 18 years ago was How the Grinch Stole Christmas. 18 is the only number besides zero that is twice the sum of its digits. There are 18 holes on a regulation golf course. Now, this is amazing. Americans eat a total of 18 acres of pizza every year. It's every day on the average. Shakespeare's Sonnet 18 is probably the most famous. Mary Shelley was 18 when she wrote the short story which would later become the novel Frankenstein. And finally, the creases on your right hand look like the number 18 in Arabic. How many looked at their hands? See, I knew you would. Okay, anyway. Now, after I got through all this, it just goes on and on, and I said, no, I have to do something better than this. You will not believe it. I opened the Gospel of St. Luke, and here's what I found. I kid you not. You can check me out if you want to. Jesus said, I tell you solemnly, there is no one who has left house, wife, brothers, parents, or children for the sake of the kingdom of God who will not be given repayment many times over in this present time and in the world to come, eternal life. Now, that's a pretty good bargain, I would say. Imagine eternal life. Now, obviously, you have to live a good life. You have to live a virtuous life and cooperate with God's graces. You know, you're beginning on a wonderful life to know what it means to give your life or to be a spouse of Christ. You're beginning this life with much generosity, so it's wonderful. So it's a great adventure, actually. Just hang in there, okay? Okay, now, if you are given this beautiful religious vocation, the community has a tremendous responsibility to see that we do everything, and I can assure you, we will do everything we can to help you on this journey to God, physically, mentally, and particularly spiritually. So we too have an obligation. We're so glad that you're one of our family now. And speaking of family, I want to thank the parents, the siblings, the friends, all of those you left generously, but they too made a tremendous sacrifice. You know, you have left a void in their life, but you can fill up that void so beautifully by your prayers, by your good works, and by your love for them. So that is a wonderful thing. So God bless you. I better go or the sisters are going to get angry because I think they've got cookies or something out there. So anyway, but we do welcome you, and we're behind you 100%. So you behind us 100%. God bless you. Thank you.
Through the intercession of St. Pope John Paul II, St. John Paul II, we pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for the repose of the soul of John Cardinal O'Connor, for Bishop Emeritus Carl Mengeling, for Bishop Earl Boyer, and all priests and religious throughout the world. Let us pray to the Lord. For our nation to respect all life and for all civil leaders throughout the world, that they would govern with moral integrity and work for true world peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For Sister Irene, Sister Monica, Sister Eilis, Sister Karen, Sister Claire, Sister Kayla, Sister Jenna, Sister Autumn, Sister Grace, Sister Jacinta, Sister Rory, Sister Mary Claire, Sister Amber, Sister Jersey, Sister Catherine, Sister Genevieve, Sister Meg, and Sister Bridget, as they enter our religious community today and begin their journey of holiness along the path of a religious vocation, that Christ's presence in the Blessed Sacrament and that the Holy Mother of God might always be their strength and their joy. Let us pray to the Lord. For the families of the new postulants, that God might richly reward each member for the sacrifice they are so selflessly making today, let us pray to the Lord. For each of us, that God might move our hearts to know him more, to follow him in truth and love, and to serve him in the manner he has chosen for each of us all the days of our lives, let us pray to the Lord.